the nobodies, to the abandoned, who couldn't see and the pain was a plan. Looking back now, Lord, I can say thank you. Now let me tell you who I am.
How do you do? Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus the Christ. It is our annual tradition to count down to the start of a new year. I believe the ending of a year and the beginning of a new year is one of the most critical times of the entire year. The countdown to the new year serves two purposes: one, to finish the year strong, and the other, to have a great start to the next year. I hope you will allow me to be your guide as we travel these last 50 days of this year. Every day, we will share a word to help us end the year strong while equally preparing for the new year. Let's get started.
Welcome to the Words to Empower podcast, featuring Bishop Frank Stewart, pastor of the Acts Ministry in Conway and North Little Rock, and now, Pastor Stewart.
Welcome back to your Acts Ministry broadcast. We're counting down to 2019, and I want to talk to you today just a little bit as we're getting set from some scriptures that are in the Bible that teaches us about the Lord. And with 32 days left, it's some things that we need to look at. I believe that it's very possible that we are doing some things wrong, that maybe we are working much harder than what we should work. The one thing that we must consider and understand is that the Lord desires for us to prosper. In 3 John verse 2 says, "Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper, be in health, even as your soul." So as we approach 2019, it's important for us to understand that God says, "I want you to prosper. I want you to be healthy." But it's all based on as your soul prospers. And then he says in Psalms 35:27, he says in the latter part of that, it says, "Let the Lord be magnified, which has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant." These are the type of verses that when you read in the Bible, it almost torments you. And then I said it because we know God can't lie. It's impossible for God to lie. Not that he won't, he can't. So the mere fact that he says these things about our prosperity, about him rejoicing in our peace, having peace, being blessed, God is happy about that. When you see these verses, it is almost a point of torment, knowing that God can't lie, but we don't see them manifested in our lives. We know that he said it. We know it's got to be true, but where's the manifestation? And I believe the reason why many things are not manifested is because we don't really know these verses. We have memorized them. We know of them. But do we really know them? Because these verses portrays the very heart of God. What God really thinks about his children. He wants them to have good health. He wants them to have prosperity. And he wants their soul to prosper. That's the God of the Bible. Now, as we move towards 2019, we have to get this in our spirit to the point that we understand that if God wants this to happen to me, and this is the point here, God wants you to have this, but you don't have it, or I don't have it, there's got to be a problem. There's a problem somewhere, you know. So what we have to do is troubleshoot. It's like when anything else that has a problem, whether it's a computer, whether it's an engine, whatever it is, electrical problem, they hook the wires up and they test and they come up with a solution on what is happening. But I'm telling you that if he wants us to prosper physically, he wants us to prosper financially and also emotionally and spiritually, then he is saying something to us. Now, what we believe is, and what we say is, that we want to prosper more than God wants us to prosper. That's not true. You do not want to be blessed more than God wants you blessed. And the reason I say that is because he wants us blessed to the point that he came and died. He came and died so we could have life and have it more abundantly. Life and that abundantly. So if he wanted me to have life in that abundantly and to the point of giving his life, then I have to look at these scriptures. I have to look at these scriptures because they challenge us every day of our lives. They challenge us as Christians. They challenge our Christianity. If God wants this for me, what is going on with me? What is happening with me? What is happening that I don't have what he died for me to have? Now, that's a pretty powerful statement. Anytime anybody died for you to have something, that is really powerful. But even when we look around, there are people that died so we could go to school, sit in the classroom, get an education, and yet and still we don't take advantage of it. I tell you, brothers and sisters, it's the same true in the case of Jesus Christ. He died so he could release the promises of God into our lives, and yet many of those promises we have never seen come to pass in our lives. Now, he says he has pleasure. That is profound to me, that he is happy about my prosperity. He is happy about my peace. He is happy when I'm happy. That's what it says in Psalms 35:27. He rejoices. He rejoices. He has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. That is a God that is a father, a God that is a parent, that when he sees his children doing well, he's happy about it. He's not distraught about it. He's not a God that want to see us do badly or poorly or struggle all the time. He's a God that loves to see us prospering. So when we look at these scriptures, and these scriptures are very challenging, very challenging, if we really would take time to look at them and to meditate on them. And the Bible teaches us that in Joshua chapter 1 and Psalms 1, that if we don't meditate on it, we're not going to receive what God wants us to have. He says we must meditate on the word of God day and night. That's in Psalms chapter 1 and Joshua chapter 1. Meditate on the word of God day and night. Then, Joshua says, you will have good success. Now think about it. 2019 is right around the corner, 32 days off. God is saying, I want you to have good success. I want you to close this year out successful. And when you go into 2019, I want you to have good success. Now, not only do he want us to have good success in this life, he wants us to be successful eternally. Now, there's a balance there. Because sometimes we think that being successful just in this life outweighs being successful eternally. It does not. God wants us to be successful, and he's looking at our eternity, not just this life. So when we see all of this that he wants for me, that he has pleasure when we receive that, and then we don't have it. I wish it was just as simple as that, but it's so many reasons why we don't have it. And it has nothing to do with God. It doesn't have anything to do with him. That's on us. You remember in the Gospel of Matthew, the father who brought his son to Jesus, and he says to the Lord Jesus Christ,
stay tuned for more of Frank Stewart. And now for some special announcements.
Thanks for partnering with the Acts Ministries. We value your service and your donations. That's why we've made it easy to make contributions to support our ministry. simply go to your web browser and click the search bar and type in actsministriesonline.org. Then click Donate Online. It's really that easy. For mobile giving, text the amount you wish to donate to 501-302-4242. That's Simple Give.
And now, more of Pastor Frank Stewart.
I brought my son to your disciples, but they could not heal him. They couldn't do it. And Jesus says to the Father, bring him to me. Bring him to me. And as you look at that and you compare the Gospels with that story, you begin to understand that Jesus was upset that they were not able to heal this boy. Now, that blows you away. Just think about that. Jesus got upset because they were not able to bring healing and deliverance to this young man. He was upset about it. He was upset about it because he should have been healed. The Father says something that is very profound. The Father says to the Lord Jesus Christ, he says to him, if you can do anything, if you can do anything. But Jesus flipped it. And he says to him, if you can believe, all things are possible. Now, I've been preaching for years, the if is not on God. The if is on us. Are we going to finish 2018 strong? Are we going to have a great start to 2019? That if is on us, not on God, not on God. He's done everything that he can and could do to make sure we're successful. He's already given. The Bible says he's given unto us all things. We talked about that a few days ago. He's given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness. He hath given. He's already done that. He's already secured that for us. He already loads us down with benefits every day. That's what he does on a daily basis. So when the Father says to Jesus, if you can do anything, Jesus comes back and says, if you can believe. If you can believe, all things are possible to them that believe. Have you ever thought about it? How challenging the Word of God is. When you read the Word of God, how challenging it is to us. It is a Word that still believes in miracles and signs and wonders. And so many times we find people that want to eliminate the signs, the wonders, the miracles, because they are judging judging the Word of God based on what is happening in their lives. It's not happening in my life, so the Word couldn't have meant this. And that is a bad way. That is a bad way to judge anything based on yourself. But when we realize that God cannot lie, the Word is still efficacious, it is still in effect today, we're still in the church age, and if these things are not happening, then it's not God. It's me. It's you. It's something that we are not doing. And I am certain, brothers and sisters, that it's just this one small thing that we may have out of sequence. One small thing. That if we would do that, it would change the lives of many of the people around us. I'm going to say that again because I really believe that. And I believe that's why the enemy today, he wants to keep us so, so busy. Because if you ever can step away from it and go into meditation mode and go into the presence of God and tell God, you said, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask of God. I am asking wisdom of you. And sit in the presence of God till you receive an answer. Not only will it impact your life, it will impact all the lives around you. So the Word of God, thank be to God that it is challenging. It's not a wimp religion. It is a very challenging religion. When the Lord says that the works that I do, you will do, and greater works. See, these are the scriptures that many have not reconciled. What do you mean reconciled? They see it, but they don't believe it can happen because they say it's the 21st century. And some way, the 21st century is supposed to disannul the word of God. And that's not true. Jesus said, I'm the same today, yesterday, and forever. He does not change in his character. His character doesn't change. His methods change, but not his character. If he said he was going to do it, he's going to do it. He can't lie. He cannot deceive himself. We have to understand that. So when we look at these great promises, and that's what the Bible tells us, that Peter said that when we look at these exceedingly great, precious promises that God has given unto us, that we haven't taken advantage of. And that's what we're talking about. We want you to get so involved as we walk towards 2019. We want you to get so involved in daily devotion, in doing what you know to do, in seeking him first. I'm going to tell you why many of these things are not done or things are not fulfilled. It is because of Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33. You might say, what is Matthew 6, 33? It's very important that you understand that, because it is a very important word. And what Matthew 6, 33 says unto us, it says to us, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto us. That is so powerful. Such a powerful text. So you run after me and I'll take care of the things. You seek me and I'll take care of the things. That's good. That is absolutely wonderful what the Lord has told us that we need to do. Because if we seek him first, seek the kingdom first and his righteousness, all these things will be added unto us. What things? All these promises. All the stuff that he has said would happen unto us. It comes through seeking him first. John says it like this in 1 John. 1 John chapter 5, John declares unto us, he says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, Jesus, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And since we know he hears us, we have what we ask for. We have the petition. So as we move towards 2019, I want you to reconcile. I want your life and my life to start to parallel more scriptures than anything else. To parallel. What does that mean? That means I read it in the word of God and I see it happening in my life. I read it in God's word. I look around, and whether that's a few days, few weeks, months, years, I see that happening in my life. Very, very important. Very, very important. So I want to leave you as we move towards 2019. We might be making this way more difficult than what it is. Very, very difficult when it's not designed to be difficult. When his whole will, his wishes, his prayer, his desires, he rejoices. He has pleasure, the Bible says, in the prosperity of his servant. He's not sad about that. Now, that's liberating, because many times we feel like God was happy when we were unhappy, or God was happy when we was being persecuted. No. He understands that, but he has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Because the Bible teaches us he doesn't have pleasure in the death of any soul that dieth. It's not God. But he is happy when we are happy. What a great and awesome God we serve. I want you to stay tuned. Keep walking with us. This is day 32. Pick up the pace. Listen intently. Pull all the words you can. Brothers and sisters, I'm telling you, the reason why we're not accomplishing many things we want to accomplish, we're not eating enough. The Bible says that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out the mouth of God. We got to eat more. You got to eat more word if you want to do more things. If you want to see the word of God explode in your life, you have to eat more. Eat it until it just comes out of our spiritual man. And we see a move of God like we have never seen it before. Stay tuned as we continue to count down to 2019. What a great year it's going to be.
For mobile giving, text the amount you wish to donate to 501-302-4242.
The Axe Church in North Little Rock is located at 1224 Franklin Street. Morning glory begins at 8 a.m. on Sunday mornings. Sunday school begins at 8:30 a.m. And for a powerful word, join us at 9:30 a.m. for our morning worship service. Bible study is each Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. At our Conway location, morning glory begins at 10 a.m. Sunday school begins at 10:30 a.m. Worship service begins at 11:30 a.m. On Thursday, our Bible class begins at 6:30 p.m. For more information, go to actsministriesonline.org or give us a call at 501-329-2055.
Thank you for tuning in to the Axe Ministry Podcast. The Axe Church is located at 1423 Indian Street in Conway and 1224 Franklin Street in North Little Rock, Arkansas. Tune in each day to hear an inspiring word from Pastor Frank Stewart.